Hello students, today we are going to learn about the topic scanline method. Let's see the introduction. The scanline method is a image space method to identify the visible surface within the scene. In this method, each scanline is processed. All the polygon surfaces intersecting that line are examined to determine which is visible. Across each scan line, depth calculations are made for each overlapping surface to determine which is the nearest to the view plane. When the visible surface has been determined, the intensity value for that position is entered into the image buffer. So as we have seen, this is an image space method. So the image buffer is there. In that image buffer, the background color value is get stored. And here we have the number of scan line, and each scan line will be processed one at a time based on the depth value. We have to assign the depth values also, and we have to make sure that there should not be any overlapping of the surfaces. And if there is any, we have to determine which is the nearest to the view plane. Now, there are two important tables, edge table and polygon table, which we have to maintain for the scan line method. What edge table will do? It contains the coordinate endpoints of each line in the scene and the inverse slope of each line and the pointers into the polygon table to connect the edges to the surfaces. So what it will contain? It will contain the endpoint coordinates of each line, slope, inverse slope of the line, and pointer into the polygon table, which connect the edges to the surfaces. Then what polygon table contains? It contains the plane coefficient, surface material properties, and other surface data. Now, as we have seen in this figure, there are two surfaces, S1 and S2. And we have here three scan line, 1, 2, and 3. And these are the vertices of the two different surfaces. Now, there is a dotted line. It shows the hidden surface. The boundary of the hidden surface means the surface S2 has a hidden boundary. The scan line crossing the projection of the surfaces S1 and S2, both the scan line passes through both the surfaces in the view plane. Now let's see the algorithm. Now for each scan line, we will begin with the each scan line. We have to scan it with the help of algorithm. So we'll consider each scan line. For each pixel XY along the scan line. Now we have to consider each and every pixel of the surface. For that, we begin with the Z buffer. So Z buffer initially set to 0 means the depth value is initially 0 and image buffer is set to the background color. For each polygon in the scene, what we have to do? We have to cover each pixel XY along the scan line by the polygon. Then what we have to do? We have to compute the Z value or the depth value of the polygon at pixel location XY. If the value of Z is less than the Z buffer value we have set to 0. So if this Z is less than 0, then we will set Z buffer is equals to Z. Means now the Z buffer will be updated to the value of Z. And the image buffer will be updated to the value of polygon color. So whatever the color it is. And the process goes on till we finish the processing of all the surfaces. So this is about the algorithm of scanline method. Now, what is the advantage of this method? Memory requirement for this algorithm is less as compared to the depth buffer method. But It works only if the surfaces do not overlap with each other. Means there should not be any overlapping of the surface. As we have seen the figure, see in the figure, the S2 was overlapped behind S1. So no overlapping should be there. In that, you can miss some of the information about the particular surface. For that, it should not work. This is all about the scanline method. Thank you.